Georgia Tech is in a leadership position. We graduate the most women engineers in the U.S. We have an enrollment of 28% women versus the national average of 18% women in our engineering fields.
The state that we're in, with the declining, continuing decline of women in engineering in the STEM fields, the workforce needs more of these skills. Women, should make up 50% of the workforce.
There's this leaking pipeline all across that career path of science and technology. So if you want more women in engineering, you have to fix all the parts of the pipeline. So you need more women interested in engineering, and then not to lose as many along the way at the different levels.
We know that having mixed and diverse teams really enables creativity and good solutions, but I'd say really from a personal point of view that it's a great career.
More so in my K through 12, we had a lot of hands-on projects, and it was just very fun and visible. We need to bring that fun factor into the companies, into the offices, and bring that into college as well. I think we lose that as we go along into and progress into engineering.
Women are half the population, and what we're doing in the U.S. currently is equivalent to using half of our brain, because women are not as represented as they need to be.
The president has said that if we could lift our game in STEM for all our citizens, that that's the most important thing we could do.
You're doing things right at Georgia Tech, continuing to make it accessible, make engineering and the sciences something that is better understood by girls even before they enter the program.
So as an institution in a leadership position in the production of women engineers and scientists, it's our responsibility to get the word out about how important this is to the rest of the nation.